BLU-link is a Harman proprietary digital audio bus technology, which allows hundreds of uncompressed digital audio channels to travel quickly and efficiently on network cables between devices. Since Harman avoids paying licensing fees with BLU-link, Harman brands can sell BLU-link-enabled products at a low price despite their impressive capabilities. BLU-link was initially developed by BSS Audio, but it has since found its way into several other Harman products, including amplifiers from Crown, input-output expanders, personal monitor controllers, and speaker processors from DBX, and mixing consoles from Soundcraft. Unlike the other three transports, BLU-link is not Ethernet-based, although there are some similarities. For example, BLU-link works with Cat5e or better cables, and each cable can be up to 100 meters in length. And just like any other gigabit Ethernet port, BLU-link ports are auto-switching, which means both crossover and straight-through cables can be used. For single cable runs longer than 100 meters, the BLU-MC1 fiber media converter allows BLU-link to travel up to 10 kilometers over single-mode fiber. Now here's where any Ethernet similarities end. BLU-link will not successfully pass through any network switch, router, or hub. Instead, BLU-link connects directly between devices in either of two topologies, daisy chain or ring. Every BLU-link-enabled device has two ports, one labeled in and one labeled out. Just connect the ports from out to in, and there's your BLU-link network. In reality, all BLU-link ports are actually bidirectional, regardless of their individual labels, but it's still very important not to connect out to out or in to in, because that will not work. This is a daisy chain, and it works just fine. BLU-link audio can travel from any source to any destination. And this is a ring, which is considered best practice because it provides fault tolerance. If any one cable or device fails for some reason, the audio will quickly and automatically self-heal by traveling around the other way. Up to 60 devices are allowed per BLU-link ring or daisy chain. BLU-link ports always pass audio only, not control. Remember, HiQnet control passes through a separate port on the device, usually labeled Ethernet, which connects to the network like this. So as you can see, by definition, BLU-link audio stays off the Ethernet network, and that's a key differentiating advantage of BLU-link. AVB, Cobernet, and Dante are supported by Harman because sometimes it's nice to send audio through network switches. But those switches often require careful programming to ensure that audio traffic doesn't corrupt or become corrupted by other network traffic. BLU-link allows you to avoid these potential problems entirely by offloading bandwidth-hungry networked audio onto dedicated cables. This increases system reliability while decreasing network strain, switch port usage, operational costs, and material costs. BLU-link is essentially Harman's cheat code for networked audio. The maximum number of channels per BLU-link ring or daisy chain is 256, assuming all devices are running at a sample rate of 48 kHz. Like Cobernet, doubling the sample rate to 96 kHz cuts the channel count in half. Unlike Cobernet, BLU-link bit depth does not vary. It's always 24 bits. BLU-link is a broadcast protocol. To demonstrate this, let's go through a simple example. A mic is connected to an analog input on one of five Soundweb London BLU-160s. Here is the BLU-link network, and we'll just leave it as a daisy chain for simplicity. And let's say each BLU-160 has an analog output, which is connected to a powered speaker. And finally, let's say the mic needs to reach all five speakers simultaneously for an all-call paging announcement. This is easily done with BLU-link. Since BLU-link is a broadcast protocol, we only have to consume one of the 256 BLU-link channels, not five, for example. Let's arbitrarily choose channel 240. Now that the mic is assigned to a BLU-link channel, it's available to all other devices. For that reason, it's practically irrelevant where you initially decide to physically connect the analog mic cable. Its signal is ultimately available everywhere. Now, if all five devices are processing the mic in the same way, then the waveforms exiting the speakers will be virtually identical. However, there will be minuscule timing offsets caused by BLU-link latency. For example, the mic will exit this speaker a tiny bit later than it exits this speaker, because the physical path to the second speaker is longer than the path to the first. To quantify it, BLU-link latency is 11 samples for the first hop, and 4 samples per hop thereafter. So, ignoring the exception to the rule, the first hop, BLU-link latency is basically 4 samples per hop. Assuming the devices are running at a sample rate of 48 kHz, 4 samples equates to 83 microseconds, which is less than 1/10 of 1 millisecond. To put this into perspective, sound itself, which can travel through the air at about 1,000 feet per second, can only travel about 1 inch over 83 microseconds. And BLU-link latency gets reduced even further when devices run at the higher sample rate of 96 kHz. Let's calculate the BLU-link latency in this system. The mic will exit this first speaker at what we'll call time 0. The mic exits this speaker 11 samples later compared to the first speaker. It exits this speaker 15 total samples later compared to the first speaker. And it exits this speaker 19 relative samples later. And this speaker 23 samples later. Take 23, divide by the sample rate, and you'll still have a number that's well under 1 millisecond. Technically, these speakers are not perfectly time-aligned, and if you're inclined, you can manually time-align them through the use of delay and some basic math. But practically speaking, offsets this small are more of an academic concern, and they can and should be ignored for almost any application. Really, they only become relevant if you're time-aligning speakers within the same cabinet. And in that case, you can manually delay things, or better yet, just connect the speakers to the same physical device. Next, let's talk about AVB,